Hello everyone and welcome to this ArcGIS Field Maps tutorial. Today I'm going to give a quick tutorial on how you can create geofences and also view and edit previously configured geofences in the Field Maps web app. So, getting started, I have already signed in to my ArcGIS Online account and opened the Field Maps web app, and now I'm going to open a map that I want to work with. So next, I'm going to navigate to the Geofences page, and this is where you can view and edit previously configured geofences or make completely new ones. So first, I will start with configuring and adding a new geofence to my map, and I'll do this by selecting Add Geofence at the bottom of the page. And as you can see on the right side, a geofence configuration menu will pop up. So I'll go ahead and start configuring my geofence by naming it Protected Zone. So this will be a geofence that will start sharing my location when I enter a protected area. I'll select the layer I want the geofence to be configured on, and I'll select my protected environment polygon layer. The map, as you can see, zooms right to that layer, so you can see the overlay of the geofence on it. And so I want it to be a geofence that shares my location when I enter this geofence area and then stop sharing my location when I go outside of it. So I'll select location sharing and I will select start on enter, stop on exit. If I want my location to stop sharing when I enter the geofence area and then to start sharing when I exit it, I could select stop on enter and start on exit. But again, I want to for this tutorial to have my location to be shared when I enter the geofence and then stop being shared when I exit it. So I'll stay with this first option. So that's pretty much it. As you can see, we've filled in all of the information needed for the geofence. The overlay, the graphic overlay of on top of the polygon changed to the location sharing symbol, letting you know that the type of action you've chosen is location sharing. So we'll go ahead and save this geofence and it's now been configured. So next, we will look at how you can edit and view a previously configured geofence. So I previously created this dog park boundary geofence, and I can press the hide geofence to hide it on my map. And I could also go to zoom 2 to look at the geofence and see it in the extent of my map. And again, if I want to hide that geofence and not have it overlaid on my map, I can press hide geofence. I could also remove it if I wanted to, but instead we're just going to focus on editing it. So we'll press the geofence, and right now I have a location alert as the action for this geofence, and this just sends me a notification right now when I exit the geofence. If I also want to have a notification pop up when I enter the extent of the geofence, I'm going to click the checkbox next to on enter. And I will create a custom message. This one will say you are now entering a dog park. And that will be the message that will pop up when I enter the geofence. So that's how you can go back and edit your geofences. I'll click save and it's ready to go. So that was a quick tutorial on how you can create geofences and also view and edit previously configured geofences in field maps. If you want to learn more about configuring geofences and field maps, I highly recommend you check out the Configure the Map help topic on the Field Maps documentation site. There's a really helpful geofences section that talks about everything you need to know about configuring geofences and field maps. Thank you.